Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. One of my favorite kind of videos to watch is buying the ads, like buying the TikTok ads. Soph from Soph Does Life does this amazingly. And I want to give it a go. So I have purchased a few skincare, body care products that TikTok was really pushing out to me. Like these are products I saw over and over and over from different creators each time. And some of them I've already given a go. Some of them I'm going to give you my first impressions and see if these sponsored products are any good. And we are going to start off with this brand Groom, who make zero waste skincare.
I just picked up this skin and hair kit worth £20 for free. And even better, they come with zero plastic packaging. The facial cleansing bar is really gentle on the skin and leaves it feeling brighter and clearer. The nourishing shampoo bar foams up fabulously and is great for all hair types. I love that it leaves my hair feeling silky smooth. And the creamy body wash bar leaves my skin feeling clean and nourished. I have a feeling that these are going to sell out very quickly, so grab yourself one while you can.
Now, I did try and grab myself one and I couldn't. I was expecting like that really nice kind of like PR packaging, but they just came like this. Three boxes in a bigger box rattling around, which is fine. I don't really care. So the shampoo bar, I'm not trying. I already know these kind of like zero packaging bars dry me out. Like dry up my scalp really bad. I got like the body bar thing. And then this is the one I'm gonna be trying out. This is the Kalar Brightening Facial Cleanser. They say it's a natural exfoliating bar. Ooh. Activated charcoal gently draws out impurities while vitamin C brightens and soothes. Perfect for acne prone and oily skin. So they go on to say, what makes this special? Well, what makes it special is apparently activated charcoal, a natural antibacterial gentle exfoliant that draws out impurities while preventing further breakouts. We know now charcoal doesn't draw out anything. It will remove what charcoal attaches to. So you have to make physical contact. The charcoal has to make physical contact to be able to wash away like impurities and all that kind of stuff. Still good. It's just the word draws out is a little bit misleading. As well as reducing the appearance of blackheads and pores. It's sebum bats. We've got shea butter, grapefruit oil as a source of vitamin C, orange oil, which my skin doesn't really like actually. They say it's free from artificial colors, palm oil, synthetic fragrance, parabens, sulfates, SLS, EDTA, and petrochemicals. None of that I really honestly care about. This is gonna be a first impression, and please bear in mind that first impressions aren't really useful as much as far as reviews go, but they are useful for me because this is how I decide what I'm gonna review further down the line, you know. First impressions are important. So let's wet my face and lather this up and see how it goes. Okay. It smells very orangey. And you know what this instantly reminds me of? Because, you know, there's not many things like this around. Is the Lush Coal Face. I think they've renamed it nowadays. But you know what? Actually, already on instant use, this doesn't feel as like instantly drying as a lot of cleansing balms tend to make my skin feel. It feels very smooth. It actually feels like a cream cleanser upon initial application. I will say though, the ingredients, charcoal, shea butter, the grapefruit, may be good if you have very oily skin, like very oily teenage skin. Can be like a little bit irritating and drying. Feels nice though, I'm not gonna lie. I kind of wanted to hate this because, no, that's a lie. Listen, I haven't had a lot of luck with zero waste products. I've mentioned before, but I scrapped a whole video of zero waste brand products because I just hated all them and I didn't want to sound like I was just shitting on zero waste products, but they tend to have the same kind of natural, clean ingredients that irritate skin and all smell like lavender and tea tree and all that kind of stuff. I'm going to go rinse this off and we'll see how my skin feels after. Okay, I may have spoke too soon. As I was rinsing it off, felt like soap. It felt like soap. You know when it starts to, you get my skin, my finger should be gliding along my skin, but it feels so rubbery and tight and like that squeaky clean, which is something we don't want from a cleanser. As I was rinsing off, I felt like I was just using Dove soap. Actually, some Dove soap's all right, but you know, like Imperial Love or whatever, you know, just a bar of soap. My skin feels very tight. Again, this might be okay if you have very oily, like teenage skin. I don't think it's for me in any way whatsoever. So I will not continue to use that. I may use this on like my feet or something like that, you know? It will get usage, just not on my face, I'm afraid. The next advert is another one I saw absolutely everywhere, but not mad about because I actually really, really wanted to try it.
Okay, so I absolutely love the Vichy Mineral 89 Serum. I use it all the time and yes, it's worth the money, But look at this. They have just brought it out in a cream format. I am so excited to try it. Let's put it to the test. And let's see. And it's already given me such a nice glow. I love the glow this has given my skin. I'm going to come back in a few hours and show you how it's looking. It's been a couple of hours and my skin is still looking hydrated. How have they done that? I have no idea. Hydrated and plump. I am obsessed. This is 100% going to be added to my skincare routine.
So, like her, I absolutely love the serum version of this. One of my favorite serums of all time. I always mention this, but a lot of people ask me why I don't still use some of my favorite products. And it's because reviewing skincare, I've got to move on. But that the Vichy Mineral 89 Serum is a serum I would stick to as a hydrating serum if I didn't have to review skincare. So this is the Vichy Mineral 89 72 Hour Moisture Boosting Cream. I'm really looking forward to trying the moisturizer. Oh, that's small. It's going to be bigger. 50 milliliters. Okay, I didn't see another size, but maybe it comes in a bigger size, or I'm just not seeing the size properly on TikTok. It looks smaller. Whilst I'm looking for long-term hydration in the feeling of my skin, I don't really mind about the look of long-term hydration because I'll be using sunscreen over the top and it won't really, you know, it won't be a fair trial of it. But I am looking for that instant dose of hydration, that feeling of hydration. Oh no. Having very dry skin after that cleanser, this feels already so nicely moisturizing and hydrating. It slips over the skin so easily. Ooh, that looks good. That does look good. A very natural glow. Nothing too dewy. Nothing too glass skin, you know. So if you do not like the dewy look, I think you will still like this as a natural look. Glow from within kind of moisturizer. A little bit seems to glide a long way. I can't really talk to the plumpness either because you'll see like these few spots I have on my face. They're all wounds, puncture wounds from where I've just had Botox and filler. So I'm a little bit swollen. So I cannot talk about the plumpness because that will be my swollen face from having filler yesterday. So they say that this is formulated with hyaluronic acid, vitamin E and B3, as well as squalane. So you get this really nice moisturized feeling without feeling greasy. Lipids to help with our skin barrier, and Vichy mineral water. I never really know what mineral waters do, to be honest. It's also fragrance free. They say it could double up as a day or night cream. And to be honest with you, it feels a little bit light for it to be like a night cream, but that's when the test of how well it locks in moisture and hydration, that's when that will come in handy. But no, I really like that. Like, my skin looks dewy. It feels hydrated and moisturized without being glowy or too dewy. Or do you mean like it looks like naturally healthy skin? So this is a product I will continue to use. So when it comes to like a hits and shits or like an end of month favorites, then that's the same thing. You know, anything. I'll give you an update on this. I'm going to keep using that. But my skin feels really nice. And like it kind of has this comforting layer on it, which I quite like. That doesn't feel greasy. I need to do that like tissue test that they do on Korean products. You know, where they throw a load of like confetti on their face. And if it sticks, it means you're greasy. I don't know how good a test that is. Next advert.
Uvamune 400 by La Roche-Posay. Incredible filter and now oil control for those with blemish-prone skin.
That was the shortest advert I think I had throughout the whole of the TikTok ads. Here it is. This is the La Roche-Posay Amphilios Uvamune 400 SPF 50+ PA 4+ oil control sunscreen. Incredible filter and now for oil-prone skin. I had that as a listen. As an influencer, I would love to see the brief for that advert because they must have said keep it as short and snappy as you could. If I handed that in, they'd be like, where's the rest of the information? But that's TikTok for you. Here it is. Now, I'm wanting to try more La Roche-Posay, especially their sunscreens. Chemical sunscreens, it's now 50-50 whether my rosacea is going to react to it or not. So this is one I'll be able to update you throughout the day on. But I never have an issue with La Roche-Posay products. So yeah, let's give it a go. I have been getting very oily in my T-zone here. The weather has started to become very, very warm here in the UK. I will be going to film at my brother's later, so I'll be able to give you a bit of an update on the oil control side of it and also how it's flaring up, if it's flaring up my skin at all. So yeah, let's see. This smells like PVA glue. I think America's Quick Craft glue. You know what you use in school? It's quite thick. They do call it a gel cream. But it does really just feel like a cream more than a gel cream. But I guess the finish is more of how a gel cream would finish on your skin. They describe it as lightweight and mattifying. It looks very dewy on my skin. I wouldn't say it's mattifying just yet. And they even call it anti-shine, but I wouldn't even say it was anti-shine. It's actually adding a sheen to my skin more than anything. I think my skin's already reacting to it. I'll give it a minute to calm down. So they say that the anti-shine, like oil-absorbing ingredients in here is perlite and zinc gluconate to help you keep shine-free all day. You say it's the ultimate SPF for sensitive complexions, struggling with breakouts, sun intolerance, or even prickly heat. So yeah, my skin is kind of getting a little bit irritated, but my skin barrier is definitely compromised around here at the moment, and I'm not sure why. So ignore that for now. That is not a fair test. I do like to go in layers rather than doing like two fingers at a time now. But yeah, I don't think this is mattifying in any way. I'm not gonna lie. I expect like a powdery finish. It feels creamy, if anything, which is quite nice, but I don't think it's mattifying. I actually look shiny. That kind of perlite kind of adds that luminosity to my skin. It's a little bit hard to get through the facial hair as well. I mean, if anything, that's giving me a shine, no? How is that matte in any way? And I only think with constant reapplication, I'm gonna be shinier. Look at the glow on my nose. I can instantly say, already say, if you are looking for a mattifying sunscreen, this is not it. In any way whatsoever. Do I physically feel matte? No, I feel like I've used a moisturizer. We'll check back in a few hours and see if I do feel matte still. But it's also given the appearance of glowy skin. I don't know, maybe if you have very oily skin and you want that dewy complexion without physically being oily, it might work. I don't feel physically matte in any way. We'll see. Okay, next one.
If I had to speak about love, I'd tell them about us. About silent conversations, the ones held between tucking hair.
Okay, so this is a product I will use tonight and show you. I already used this a couple nights ago out of excitement, but this is the Skin Choice Breakthrough Patch Classic Nose, and these are 10 nose patches. You might recognize these kind of products because Peace Out do a very similar thing. These are just hydrocolloid patches, but in big patches for like your nose. So often seen as a better alternative to peel off nose pore strips, you know, the ones that kind of like have that adhesive, you peel them off, you get a satisfaction of seeing all like the black hairs and the little hairs and all that kind of stuff in them. This just kind of lays on your skin. It essentially kind of like collects all the oils and gunk from your nose. Take off in the morning and have a nice clear nose. I absolutely love these as an alternative to nose pore strips. I still use nose pore strips once every so often, but if you wanna wake up with a pretty poreless looking nose, this is the kind of product to go for. What I will say is if you have somewhere to be early, I wouldn't use these because they do wrinkle up during the night and kind of leave a little wrinkle in your skin for a few hours after waking up. A few hours, about half a day. But yeah, I already know these work. I absolutely love them so, so much. What I love about this particular brand compared to others is their patches are bigger. So they can fit all types of nose shapes and sizes. For me, they cover a lot more space than a lot of the kind of like daintier nose pore ones do, nose patches do. I always feel like they're always made for smaller noses and they don't quite cover, reach the whole bridge of my nose, but these cover some really good ground. So I really, really like those. This, oh God, this is a brand I saw over and over and over and over and over, like to the point where I had to say, like, I'm not interested. Stop advertising this to me.
Ladies, I'm ranking these as the top products for underarm sweat and odor. This underarm lotion is so effective on all fronts. This helps stop odor at its source instead of just masking it with fragrance like some other products I've tried. The lotion glides on smooth and dries quickly. My favorite is Cucumber Splash. It's a fresh and cool scent without overwhelming me. I felt dry and smelled fresh the entire day, even when I was super active. This company makes sweat products not just for underarms, but for the entire body. So if you sweat in other places like the thighs, face, scalp, and more, they've got you. Click the link below to try them out.
So this is the Carpe Sensitive Skin Antiperspirant Underarm Lotion. They say it's number one dermatologist recommended sweat brand. And the whole the whole point of this brand is it's meant to be for people who really, really sweat. I bought the face lotion as well, along with like an SPF, a few other little bits, which I'd love to try with some light exercise, see how well it does. But the whole point is it's meant to keep you sweat free. I have a few issues with this product. Number one, I haven't used this for maybe 4 days. It was completely flat when I like used it, you know, rubbed it on my armpits. The product just tends to kind of like leak up through the lid. Do you know what I mean? Like it just tends to like be there. So that's kind of a waste. Like I can see it moving now. So that's a bit of a waste. Also, I'm not a heavy sweater. I don't sweat that much, but I do love a deodorant that I can really, really rely on for like when I go to events, because there's a lot of people in a room, you get very sweaty, very hot, it's all very close. So I love a deodorant that I can put on and know I'm not going to sweat. I went to a Space NK event to interview Sabrina and Idris Elba about their new skincare line, thinking this deodorant's going to have my back, like I'm going to be fine. It was very hot, got picked up. It took about 2 hours to get to the Space NK store. The Space NK store was boiling. There was no air conditioning on. Huge crowds of people everywhere. I was in a little room where I got set up and eventually interviewed the Elbas. This did nothing for me. I have never sweat so much in my life. Like, and I don't usually sweat. And I needed this time. I didn't smell, luckily, because I use my Pit Rock spray. This did nothing for me, absolutely nothing. Like that woman in that video said that it kept her sweat free even when she was active. I don't know how, because that did absolutely nothing for me whatsoever. So as somebody who sweats moderately, I cannot recommend this brand to keep you sweat free. So I dread to think those who sweat a lot, what experiences they have had. Let me know if you've used it before. Maybe I just got a crap batch. I don't know. I don't recommend it. It's not for me. I will never use it again. Okay, here's a product that is for me.
Does anybody else get these bumps on their arms? I never knew how to get rid of them, but I think I finally found something that works. This is the Hello Clean Micronutrient Wash. You just shake it up, it will remove the minerals and hard water and balance out the pH level of your skin, leaving everything feeling so smooth and hydrated. Hands down, the best thing I've tried for my dry skin, and definitely a must have if you live in a hard water area.
So I don't live in a hard water area, but I do enjoy this product. I've been using it, where is it? We're up to here. I've been using it for like probably 4 weeks now. And I originally bought this because the kind of like bi-phase formula really attracted me to it. You know, like all those essences you get, like the Cyracle, their kombucha essence, really attracted me to it. The kind of like bumpiness, the KP kind of thing. What I will say is I haven't seen any difference with the KP bumpiness. So I'm going to go back to like my Peach and Lily product, because I know that works. That keeps everything at bay really, really well. But I will say matcha, niacinamide, panthenol, microalgae, it's really soothing. It feels really nice. And I say soothing because I've been out in the sun a little bit and I got like a little bit burnt back here. I wasn't wearing sunscreen on my body because I forgot. I literally went out for like 30 minutes. Leave me alone. But it's been really soothing. And I do feel really nicely moisturized when coming out the shower. I do use like a lotion after, but my skin doesn't feel dry or tight. It cleanses well. It gives a nice foam, like it comes out as a foam, but it gives a nice foam as well when you lather it up. I do want to take this to London and kind of see, because the London water fucks up my skin. Like my eyes are still like rashy from the hard water in one of the hotels I stayed at. So I would like to take this to London with me and kind of, I don't think it travels well, to be honest, and see how well it does. But this is in my shower, hence the dirtiness of the lid. I use it every single day. I absolutely love it. It's one of my favorite, probably body cleansers of all time. So I'm glad I kept getting served that advert, because I was tempted to buy it every time I saw it, and I finally did. I have bought their shower head, which is like a filter, but I think that's a pre-order, so that's not coming yet. So that'll be in another video. But if you see this, grab it. It's really, really nice. Is it anything crazy special? Like, no, if you already have a favorite shower gel, carry on using it, shower cleanser. But if you just want to try something new and you want your body to feel nice when you step out the shower, this is a really nice one to go for. So that is it. I'm going to finish getting ready and do my hair. Let me know if you tried any of these products before. What products you keep seeing adverts for over and over on TikTok. I have more videos and more products I want to try. But let me know any of your suggestions in the comments. You've got some more product reviews here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.